ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back Reeves.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the afternoon session. To kick things off and to harness the energy of this room, we are going to try something we're calling speed date for like 2,000 people, okay? Now, if you've never been on a speed date, it's an encounter designed to get people to get to know each other better. In our case, we have 15 questions. You don't have to think about them that much. In fact, you should go with your gut. The louder we are with this, the more opinionated we are with this, the better this is gonna go and the better data we'll get about who we are as a group. Why don't we turn the lights on, actually? Why don't we turn the house lights up? Yeah, we get to see each other. Wow, there's quite a bit of you for our speed date. And let's establish a base level of noise, okay, just to see how loud we can be. We do need to establish a base level. Let's pretend you have had exactly 1 year with no threat actor activity and all your shares just vested today. So let's hear how loud that would be. Oh, there you go. That's excellent. Perfect. That's all we need to do. The first five questions we have for you are 50-50 questions. These are questions that reasonable people can go either way on, okay? But you really need to go with them to figure out who we are. And these are some of the toughest questions facing society today. Let's just get right into it, okay? You're just going to shout this out. You can applaud. You can shout it out. The first question, probably the toughest question: would you rather have unlimited sushi for life or unlimited tacos? Say it again. This, from where I stand, this is clearly a tacos-leaning crowd. From where I stand, I'm just saying. Two, it's visual, okay? Same thing, very difficult question. Which is better, over or under?
Over.
Clearly over. Although, you unders also sound like you really care, too, so good for you. Over, you're sounding mean. Three, think about this one a little bit, and then I'll do a, you know, A or B poll, okay? If you had a superpower, would you rather have flight or invisibility? Think about it. Flight or invisibility, superpower. Let's do a poll. Who says flight? Who says invisibility? Ooh, I might have to be the tiebreaker on that one. Let's just call it even, okay? All right. Four, same thing. Think about it a little bit. Would you consider yourself more of a hunter or a gatherer? Think about a hunter or gatherer. In fact, I want you to shout out on this one so I can hear the sort of like the gender of these things. I think it might be interesting. Who says hunter? Who's as loud as you can? Who says gatherer? It's a hunter crowd. Sorry, that's just what it is. Five, same thing. Now, I know these things aren't mutually exclusive, but let's pretend like they are, okay? Would you rather have good things happen or interesting things happen? So the good things are probably not interesting, and the interesting things are probably not good. Think about it for just a moment. Let's take a poll. Who says good things? Loud? Who says interesting things? Okay, well, of course, you're security people. You're like, good things, please, for the love of God. Okay, now, we also have a bonus question for you, okay? Would you rather fight one horse-sized Helen Mirren or 100 duck-sized Helen Mirrens, right? And obviously, this is a trick question. I met Dame Helen Mirren. Any combination of Helen Mirrens will kick your butt, okay? So that was just a palate cleanser. This is just to get you to our final 10, okay? Let's have the music come up, right? These next 10 questions are not 50-50. They're the opposite. Some of them don't even get close to that. What we're gonna do is we're gonna give you 10 statements. If one of these statements pertains to you, we'd like you to stand up. Do it quickly, right, briskly, and just see what we got in the room, okay? If one of these statements is you, go ahead and stand up and let's see what we've got. First question, first statement, I guess. I am an RSA conference rookie. Rookie means first year. If it's your first year at RSA, stand up, take a look at you. In fact, the rest of us, let's welcome you. Good for you, that's a lot of folks. That's a big percentage. Number seven, this number gets higher and higher every year. I am a woman. If you identify as a woman, go ahead and stand up. Let's see it. Yeah, and give yourselves a hand. All right, that's pretty good. Number eight, I'm very curious about this. I am not on social media. That means four things: Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, or LinkedIn. If you don't have any of those four things, stand up. You're like unicorns out there. Look at you. You're so beautiful and proud too. Most of you are waving emphatically. Okay, number nine, this is a percentage that goes up in society. I'm curious what it's like in this room. I am a step-parent. If you're a step-parent, stand up. You do a hard job, step-parents. Let's give it up for step-parents. That ain't easy. This next percentage is going to get higher and higher every year, maybe for decades. I really kind of intrigued by it. I remember a great-grandparent. You had 8 great-grandparents. Did you meet one of them? If you remember a great-grandparent, you're lucky enough. I'm one. Let's stand up. Let's welcome the ancestors into the room. Yeah, fantastic. All right. Hi, Nana. 11. I have broken more than 3 bones. Not at one time, just lifetime. If you've broken more than... Actually, why don't you hold up how many you have broken? Because there's a lot of you. And high-fiving. Careful with the high-five if it's a... Yeah, you 5 bones? Do we have more than 5 bones? More than 5 bones? Let's have an auction. Do we have 7 bones? Anybody? Do we have anybody that's broken 10 or more bones? Really? Wow. Okay, good for you. I would hang out with you, but you're dangerous, so let's... 12. I have never had my heart broken. If you've never had your heart broken, go ahead and stand on up, and we'll marvel at you, I guess. Anybody? Going once? Nobody? Nobody? You're shy? All right, okay, good. 100%, it's a sweep. 13, let's do some geography on this one. 13, I was born in a different country from where I live now. You have a house someplace, but you were born in a totally different country. You are an immigrant. Stand up, let's see who you are. And let's applaud you, actually, because you get the stuff done. Yes. And 14 is kind of the flip side of things. I was born within 100 miles of this room. Where are my Northern Californianers at? Let's see. Okay, right, just quick to stand up. Ooh, not that many, but thank you, by the way, for hosting the rest of us. And 15. Now, we're not going to put you on the spot, but we do want to recognize you. Statistically, there should be at least 5 of you, maybe as many as 17. We're not going to sing, but if this applies to you, please stand up. I was born on March 6th. I was born on March 6th. I was born on March 6th. How about I was born March 1st through March 7th? Happy birthday, y'all, and welcome to the session.